Hi there, my name is Michael Sanders and I'd like to show you some of my quick and clever acrylics techniques working from a photograph. And initially we're going to do a thumbnail sketch from the photograph so that we can distill the scene and improve on the photograph to start our painting. So what I'm going to do to start with is work through a little list of working from a sketch. Telegraph poles aren't really that interesting. They can be moved or left out. Cars, I don't want to put those in. The changes I want to make, changes to where the cottages are. The focal point here are the cottages and we can't see much of them. So if I lower the hedge, maybe put a gate in, I'd like to reduce the size of the road in order that it looks more countrified, more like a little pathway perhaps. And enlarge, I'd like to enlarge the hill behind so that it doesn't conflict with the roof line of the cottages. At the moment it goes quite close to the chimneys and it looks a little bit disruptive there. So I'm going to start with my sketch and I'm going to start with raising the hill in the background. This will be a tonal study. Never work from a photograph without first doing a plan. That's the trick. If you can make a few changes, we can always improve on a photograph. And I'm doing that now. I'm just going to put the very simple basic shapes in, emphasizing certain things and leaving out others. This is very simple, but it means when I start my painting, I'll be able to refer to this and work out where my tonal values are going to be. It's always possible to improve on a photograph. So what I'm going to do is now put in tonal values here, just showing myself for future reference when I come to transfer this, that the hill is going to be darker than the cottages. We'll put in a few little extra chimneys here. We'll change the roof of the cottage to be lighter than the distant hill as well. And there are some trees on the right there. Trees are good for tones and accenting. The hedge works okay. There are a few little fence posts sticking up there. Working in acrylics can give you a watercolour effect quite easily. It's always worth thinking in terms of adding the occasional medium to the acrylics. And I've got something called a flow enhance, which will make the acrylics flow like a watercolour does. So I think as a sketch, I don't need to put too much in. I just need to have enough so that I've got an idea where I'm going to go. So we're now going to transfer that onto the watercolour paper. Related back to my sketch now, I can see that the hill comes in from there and comes down. I'm not doing an awful lot of detailed drawing on this. The spontaneity I want is in the brushwork and my planning has already been done. I'm breaking the roof line up slightly just to make this a little bit more interesting. The gate, we'll put a gateway in here. The hedge we'll put in for now just to show where things are there. The shed, I was debating whether to leave out the shed, but it is a nice shape and there's a corrugated roof which we can maybe make as an orange. The road coming in here, curving round the hill. This is Dartmoor and it's quite hilly, and a range of hills in the background will certainly give us the look that we're after of being a rural scene with small mountains, large hills in the background. Road curving round to the side. I'm just going to put in simply where I want my windows to be. I'm not counting windows. Doesn't matter if we leave one or two out. And maybe the hint of a porch or something behind the gate so that we can look through to the cottage underneath the gate and behind the gate. So that's working well. And I've transferred as much as I need to now. So we'll start mixing up the paints. Just one last check, everything's there from the sketch. I don't need to put any tonal values on here with a pencil. Now I'm going to work in colour. So what I'm going to do now is start mixing some colours. I've got on my palette ultramarine, and I'm going to initially put a little bit of ultramarine into a little puddle of water, and I'm using Bockingford 200 pound watercolour paper. I'm going to add a burnt sienna, but I'm working on one palette where my acrylics are and I'm putting some colour into the adjacent palette. I've got a cerulean blue, I'm going to dilute that as well, lifting it from one palette, putting it into another. The more palettes you have and the more you can separate the colours, the less likely it is that you're going to get muddy colours. I've got a little bit of quinacridone magenta for a purpley colour here, a lemon, And what we're going to do now, I'm going to start on the sky, and I'm going to just damp the area of sky with a hake brush. This is a goat hair brush, and it carries quite a lot of paint, but I'm just going to use some water and just damp the area of sky and the area of hill. Not soaking wet, just damp. I've got some kitchen roll handy in case I get spills and dribbles coming down. So it's always handy to have some kitchen roll. And they're going to, that's going to be used to lift out some cloud shapes as well. So I'm mixing my ultramarine with a little bit of burnt sienna to give me a greyish tinge to the sky. And we're going to apply that. Then I'm going to add a darker ultramarine and mix it with a bit of the magenta to give me a purpley grey for the hills. So the sky with just a couple of touches working across, and it's a greyish, dingy kind of a sky, but I'm going to enliven it by lifting a few clouds out. Just cloud shapes in watercolour, relatively easy to do with a kitchen roll. We can just lift a few out, just lift the shapes out where I want them. I think a little bit of cerulean dropped in here and there. There's a little bit of blue coming in on the right hand side, a little bit of light at the end of the tunnel for this weather. And a little bit of extra ultramarine, a little bit more burnt sienna to darken this a little bit. Hint of magenta in there, and we'll get some of these purpley clouds superimposed on the top, and then I'll work back in and lift a little bit of cloud shape out for the sky. We'll just get a little bit of kitchen roll, lift some of that, and without waiting for it to dry, I'm going to continue with a dark purpley grey. A nice grey is made with ultramarine and burnt sienna. And when I've got the bluey grey that I want, I'm going to add a little bit of magenta to that. Quinacridone magenta. Lovely colour. Bit of a difficult word to say, but a lovely colour. And on we go. So my hill, I'm going to work down. This will flow into the background slightly and be slightly fuzzy. So I'm going to put this on and then we'll possibly wait for it to dry. This is, because it's acrylic, the subsequent layers, unlike watercolour, although this is a watercolour technique, won't be shifted by layers coming in on top. So the next layer I put on is actually going to remain and not move under painting. In watercolour paintings done with watercolour, we have this problem where we've got the layer of paint that's going on the top moving the layer underneath, and that can cause problems. I've just realised I've left one of the chimneys out when I did the drawing, so we're going to put another little chimney in there just for the sake of accuracy. Now I'm going to probably go over this again. And that's my initial first layer for the moorland background. I'm just washing an all-rounder brush called an all-rounder. I'm just washing a little bit of water onto that, and I'm using the brush now to drop some colour into here just to get an edge, just to get a softer edge to that line. The all-rounder equates to a number 8 of brush in size. We need to darken this distant hill a little bit, so before it dries we just go back in and modify that, bring that down, so we've now got a nice dark brooding hill there in the background. Allow a few minutes for that to dry.